We wanted to show you how to do that.
Would you do a little bit of that in the mood that you did for us in class to show people where some of this came from?
Now you've got me all 10 different.
I'm sorry.
No, he's referring to a tune we worked on this week, Foggy Mountain Special, which is a totally kind of different sounding tune than pretty much everything Earl cut. It had a kind of a boogie-woogie kind of a swing type beat to it. A big band influence is what I was talking about, and he wanted me to play. I was just telling these guys that Earl Scruggs was not only influenced by the local old-time musicians that he grew up around, playing tunes like Sally Ann that we played, and Sally Gooden, Cumberland Gap, all these tunes, we associate them with Earl Scruggs, but they'd actually been played before he was born. Old-time music and guys playing clawhammer style and that kind of thing, right there in the Piedmont, Carolina, where he was born. But at the same time, when Earl Scruggs was a teenager coming along in the late 30s, early 40s, if you turned on the radio anywhere, he got in the car, cut the radio on, pretty much it would have been a big band, something going on like a Guy Lombardo, Glenn Miller. That kind of music was the king right then. It was equivalent to Beyonce today or Lady Gaga or somebody like that. They were huge. And I mean, anytime you got anything on, they were on. So they had to be influenced by it somewhat. And I was showing them just the real driving beat of a big band sound. And I hear a lot of old banjo players, pioneer guys, that try to show guys back in the 40s the three-finger roll with one tune, and it was called In the Mood. That was a big Glenn Miller hit, huge hit. And if you listen to the timing and the sound of that particular song and compare it with Foggy Mountain Special, which Earl Scruggs recorded later on, you can definitely hear the influence that the big band music had on Earl. And all bluegrass, you can hear it in Bill Monroe's music early on as well. So I just played just a little bit of a clip of that at the end here. Going back in tune from all that Earl's breakdown. It pretty much started off like... Second part of In the Mood there. You wanted to know it, now you
could almost have the same rhythm track.
There's a couple other things just worth noting on that, and one of them is that I know whenever guys like Bela Fleck and Tony Trischka came along and started playing avant-garde, you know, jazz tunes on the banjo, that was nothing new. Earl was playing jazz on the banjo, you know, when he started, so doing that kind of thing was never really an outside thing. But the other thing is that I've heard people say, or I've started seeing it written on banjo websites and things, where people say, well, Earl played everything just perfectly straight time, yada yada yada, he never played with a bounce or a swing or any of that kind of thing. That thing swung, buddy, I tell you, that was Earl was hip.
John Henry, okay?